Hello students, welcome to the Unacademy YouTube's classes. Yes, welcome to all. How are you all? Hope you are doing good. Yes students, okay, let me start the session today. Once again, welcome to all the students on this YouTube platform. Unacademy has started a PLUS program for KSET 2021 aspirants. It is a comprehensive batch. So in this comprehensive batch, complete syllabus will be covered. Tips and tricks by top educators. So topic wise practice questions you will get. So it is one of the beautiful option. Practicing the objectives chapter wise gives a lot of confidence. The same time you are going to get a full length mark test also. So students, once you do this full length mark test, definitely you will be at the topper side. Definitely you will crack the KSET 2021 without doubt at all. So because here we are following the scientific method. So first we are making you perfect by quality teaching and trips. Then topic wise practice questions. Here we are going to solve topic wise. Then we will enter into the full length mark test. So for all this, we have the plan. For 1 month plan, you can try it with the 2250 rupees. Okay, for getting 10% instant off, you can use the code of Gauss Live, GHOUSELIVE. So in this, you can have different plans also. You can have a look on this 1 month plan, 6 months plan, 12 months plan. Do remember, the trial price is for only new subscribers. Okay, then outlines of this course, you can have points on your screen. So premium content. So good quality research material you will get in this. So structured live classes on dedicated live doubt sessions. So another important, very beautiful part of the Unacademy Plus is you'll get regular quizzes for your self-analysis. There is a separate batches for complete preparations. So there will be a test series for DPPS, full length marks with analysis. So another important point to all KSET 2021 aspirants is subscription gives rise to your unlimited access students. So waiting for the students to join. So those who all already joined, I'm welcoming you all on this YouTube platform. So students, today our topic of the day is, structure of polynucleotide chain. So structure of polynucleotide chain, we are going to study in NCERT as heading of nature of bond linking in monomers. Okay, you can just check it, students. In NCERT, the structure of polynucleotide chain will come under the heading of nature of bond linking monomers in polymer. Students, before going to know, let me tell you. So nucleotide, okay, we need to talk about nucleotide. What is a nucleotide? And you see, you take nucleic acid, students. Nucleic acids, you know, nucleic acids are what all there? DNA and RNA, these two are nucleic acids. So when DNA and RNA are the nucleic acids, they are the polymers. Now, what are the simplest units of polymers here? Yes, the monomer of nucleic acid is nucleotide. That's the reason why we call DNA as polynucleotide chain. DNA as what, students? Polynucleotide chain. So this point you have to keep in your mind. DNA is a polynucleotide chain. Then, so students, here we need to talk about nucleotides. So nucleotides having three important components. The first component is nitrogenous base. Very first component is nitrogenous base. Second important is sugar.
Second important thing is sugar, and third one is phosphate. Third one is phosphate. So you need to understand, students, here in the nucleotides, the three important basic structures will be there. So what are those here? Nitrogenous base, sugar, and phosphate. Nitrogen base, sugar, and phosphate. So now these are linked together and forms one nucleotide. These are linked together and forms the one nucleotide. So students, today our topic is we are going to study in detail about the nature, how the bond is going to be present. Student, as you all knows, DNA helix are two helix, right? One strand runs from 2-3', the another runs from 3' to 5'. You know that both strands are anti-parallel, right? The both DNA strands are anti-parallel. One strand runs from 5' to 3', and whereas another runs from 3' to 5'. But students, you have to focus here. Between the two strands, suppose here A is there, means here thymine will be there, and here guanine means here cytosine will be there. So what is the bond present between these two? AT is double bond, G is triple bond, right? So student, many students what they'll think is, what is the bond present in a polynucleotide chain? What is the bond present in a polynucleotide chain? If that is a question, many students immediately they will tell hydrogen bonds. Many students they will tell hydrogen bonds. But students, what is the truth and what is the fact here? The fact here is hydrogen bonds are present between the two strands of DNA. Between the two strands of DNA. But whereas in a single chain, this is a single chain. So this single chain is nothing but what it is? Polynucleotide chain. Polynucleotide chain. Students, here what you have to keep in your mind is, yes, it should be a perfect. So don't answer hydrogen bonds. Okay. If the question is what is the bonds present between two strands of DNA, then absolutely your answer is correct. What is your answer at the time? Hydrogen bonds. But if the question comes, what is the bond present between within a strand or within a polynucleotide chain? So that answer is going to be what, students? Phosphodiester bond. Okay, phosphodiester bond. So now you understand now. So what topic today we are going to talk about is, yes, the linking between polynucleotide chain, right? So what is the bond present between the nucleotide? Bond present between nucleotide is, yes, you know, student, phosphodiester bond. The bond present between nucleotide is phosphodiester bond. Phosphodiester bond. Yes, superb. Now, so now, what is the condition for the formation of phosphodiester bond? And what is the requisite for the formation of phosphodiester bond? If the question is like this, then immediately you need to think about, yes, some conditions. What is the condition here? One, you see here, first point, 3' OH group of one nucleotide. Obviously, this is related to sugar. 3' OH group of one nucleotide, and another one is 5' phosphate group of another nucleotide. Another nucleotide. So, students, you need to focus here. What is the bond present between the nucleotides? Means very clear, that is a phosphodiester bond. Simple. You are very clear on this. Now, the question is, what is the condition for the formation of phosphodiester bond? What should be required for the formation of phosphodiester bond? Right? That is important. So, for that, I am teaching you, that is, it should have 3' OH of one nucleotide and 5' phosphate of another nucleotide. Students, here, you know, this phosphodiester bond only, we are calling it as sugar phosphate bond. This phosphodiester bond only, we are calling it as what? Sugar phosphate bond. What do you mean by sugar phosphate bond? It's nothing but backbone of DNA. Backbone of DNA. So, you have to understand here also, the question may come like this. What is the backbone of DNA? What is the type of bond which forms the backbone of DNA? So students, for that your answer is going to be phosphodiester bond only. Okay, the phosphodiester bond only, in short we are calling it as sugar phosphate bond. So what is the prerequisite, what is the condition for the formation of phosphodiester bond? As I already mentioned you guys, yes, very simple. As I already mentioned you, what is the bond present here? Yes, sugar of which direction it should be? 3 prime means sugar. 3 prime means sugar, and whereas 5 prime means phosphate. Okay, 5 prime phosphate. So prime means succeeding 5 prime phosphate group of another nucleotide. You see 3 prime and 5 prime positions. So here phosphate you have OH, O minus double bond of O. OH, OH is there. Students, you see, again you may get a doubt. Sir, what is the bond? Okay, present between that you know. What type of reaction it is? What type of reaction it is? So obviously it is a dehydration reaction. Nothing but condensation reaction. What do you mean by dehydration or condensation reaction? What do you mean by dehydration? You see this reaction here. Water is removed. Water is removed. Students, you are very clear. If water is removed, then it is called as a what? If water is removed, then it is called which reaction? Yes, dehydration reaction or condensation reaction. It's very simple. You see here how this H2O is eliminating here. Observe very carefully. Yes. You see here OH and H. OH and H. So obviously what happened here? A bond formed here. You observe this. This is nothing but phosphodiester bond. You can clearly see third position OH group and fifth position phosphate group is there. And between this OH and OH group, what happened? Condensation reaction occurred and water molecule eliminated. Okay, so if water molecule eliminated in the reaction, that is called dehydration reaction. So students, almost all the bonds like peptide bond, glycosidic bond, right? That will be the dehydration reactions only. That will be dehydration reaction only. Okay, because water molecule come out. How water molecule will come out of the reaction? Due to the water, OH and OH, water molecule will be removed here. So now this is called phosphodiester bond. This is called phosphodiester bond. Now you may get one doubt. Sir, why you call diester bond? Guys, you are observing my point. Why we call diester bond? What is the need of calling diester bond? We can call ester bond also now. Because you see, this is one ester bond. See, now all children, you need to focus here. Why we call this is a diester bond? Why we call this a diester bond? So that time, students, you need to focus here only one point, that is what? Phosphodiester means, you see, this is one ester bond, first ester bond, this is second ester bond. You see, phosphate bond, you see here, ester bonds are present on either side of the phosphate. Okay, so ester means, you know, O, CH2O, here O, here also CH2O, right, you see. So if O is there, simply it is nothing but ester bond. So here, because of having two ester bonds either side of the phosphate, this bond we are calling it as what? Phosphodiester bond. Students, many students, they don't know. They know bond present is phosphodiester, very simple. But if I ask, let me show where the two ester bond means, they'll feel difficult. They'll feel confusion here. So there is no confusion. So with this class, I want to make you very clear why we call the bond is phosphodiester bond. You see, phosphodiester, surrounding phosphate, two ester bonds are present. So if two ester bonds are present, that is called as phosphodiester bonds. You see, students. Okay, you can see this. So why we call phosphodiester bond? You can clearly see this in a knowledge cloud. You see here, ester bond on either side of the phosphate, it is called as phosphodiester bond. That's what I told you right now. Ester bond is forming on the either side of the phosphate. See this arrow mark, guys. How this arrow mark is indicating? Yes, once again, observe this arrow mark, guys, everyone. Yes, students, meanwhile you can ask your doubts through chat box in YouTube. So that happy to clear all your doubts related to this topic, structure of polynucleotide chain. You can chat me, please. Now, next point you see here, nucleic acids exhibit a wide variety of secondary structures. For example, one of the secondary structure exhibited by DNA is the famous Watson and Crick model. Student, you see here, according to this model, DNA exists as double helix. According to this model, DNA exists as what, guys? Double helix. So, what form of DNA Watson Crick proposed, as all you guys are aware, that is B form of DNA. That is which form of DNA? B form of DNA. Very good, simple, very good. Now, students, you observe here the structure of DNA having two strands. Okay, one strand is running from 5 prime to 3 prime. The another is from 3 prime to 5 prime. Superb. So that's why strands are very first point in Watson Crick model we used to talk is strands are anti-parallel. People think, sir, both are parallel only, na? Then how you could call it anti-parallel? Yes. So the anti-parallel we are calling because of the polarity, right? Because of the polarity. So one is 5 prime to 3 prime, the other is from 3 prime to 5 prime. So students, I want to make you very clear. So here is the form of DNA explained by Watson Crick model is B form of DNA. So in this, students, you see here very clearly, you can see this sugar phosphate backbone also. You can see this sugar phosphate backbone also. Guys, you can observe here sugar phosphate. Yes. So this picture only, guys, I have made it as widen view here, very simple. You see here, I want to tell you, so in the beginning of my session I told you already what is the bond present between two strands of DNA. I repeat again, what is the nature of bond, or what is the bonds present between two strands of DNA? Yes, I told you very clear, it is hydrogen bonds. You see, students, this is 5 prime to 3 prime end, this is 3 prime to 5 prime end. You can see this is 5 prime to 3 prime, this is 5 prime to 3 prime, anti-parallel. It's very simple. Now, you see, this is cytosine is there, so this is guanine, you know, tadalafil, right? Guanine, cytosine, thymine, adenine. Purine binds with pyrimidine, pyrimidine binds with purine. Simple, very good. Now, if you observe what is the bonding present here, see, he mentioned here which bond it is, sugar phosphate bond. You see this also, which bond is there? Sugar phosphate bond is there. So you see here, this is the nucleotide structure. You see, this is the nucleotide structure. Observe very carefully guys, this is the nucleotide structures. So what should be nucleotide consist of, please let me know. What should be nucleotide consist of? Superb. Nitrogen base, sugar phosphate. Three are there, another nucleotide. Nitrogen base, sugar phosphate, right? Another like this. The same opposite side also, nucleotide will be there, sugar phosphate. Here also you see. But you see, the nitrogen base only form the bonds. Nitrogen base forms the bond. Forms the bonds. Hydrogen bonds. But within the strand, here students you have to focus, within the strand, which bonds? Phosphodiester. Within the bond, students, phosphodiester bond. Within the strand, phosphodiester. Between strands of DNA, yes, the answer is hydrogen bonds. The answer is hydrogen bonds. Students, you can see clearly here. between two strands hydrogen bonds within a strand phosphodiester bond. Students, hope you all understand. You can raise your questions through chat box in your YouTube. Yes, another important point, students. The two strands of polynucleotides are anti-parallel because they run in opposite direction. That's what I told you earlier. Then the backbone is formed by, yes, sugar phosphate. This sugar phosphate only, we're calling it as what? Yes, phosphodiester bond. The sugar bond only, we're calling it as phosphodiester bond. The sugar phosphate bond only, we're calling it as phosphodiester bond. Another picture, guys, you see here very carefully. The nitrogen bases are projected more or less perpendicular to the backbone, but face inside. So if question comes, where nitrogen bases are projected, towards outside or towards inside? Towards outside or towards inside? So that point of time, your answer is inside. You see, students, how nitrogen bases are projected? Towards inside only, right? Even cytosine also, see here. Yeah. See this. So what I want to tell to you is, yes, nitrogen bases are projecting towards inside. Nitrogen bases are projecting towards inside. Students, you see here the pictures very carefully. Within the two strands hydrogen bonds, within the strand sugar phosphate backbone. Now one turn diameter is how much? You see here, you take this as structure, okay? You take like this, students, you know, different. This is 5 prime to 3 prime and this is 3 prime to 5 prime. Just I am making this. If you take this dimension, students, if you take these dimensions, yes, we know it is nothing but 3.4 nanometers, or convert into angstrom is 34 angstroms. Okay, now here, how many base pairs will be present per turn? How many base pairs present per turn? Then what is your answer, students? If the question is like this, how many base pairs per turn, then what is your answer should be? What is your answer should be? Yes, answer is 10 base pairs, because you're talking about B form of DNA. 10 base pairs means what? This side 10, that side 10. So one base pair is equal to how many nucleotides, guys? Two nucleotides. One base pair is equal to two nucleotides. So 10 base pairs are present. You can also convert in the form of nucleotides also. If you want to convert in terms of nucleotides, let it be 20 nucleotides. So be careful. If the question comes like this, how many base pairs per turn? How many base pairs per turn? If that is your question, then obviously you may use either base pairs or turn. Okay, students. And this diameter you see here, diameter is how much here? 2 nanometers. So 2 nanometers nothing but, 2 nanometers nothing but, convert in angstrom, it is 20 angstroms. It is 20 angstroms. You see, students, adenine and guanine are one strand compulsory base pairs with thymine and cytosine of another strand. That's what I'm telling here. Read this point carefully. Read this point carefully, guys. Adenine and guanine are one strand compulsory base pairs with thymine and cytosine of other strand respectively. So there are two hydrogen bonds between A and T. You see here, AT. Observe these, guys. Here A, here T. So how many bonds, hydrogens? Two are there. Two are there. Now G and C, how many are there? Just count it. 1, 2.
1, 2, 3. So each strand appears like a helical staircase because of antiparallelism. Each strand appears like a helical staircase because of antiparallelism. Each step of ascent is represented by base pairs. Then at each step of ascent, the strand turns at 36 degrees. At each step of ascent, the strand turns by 36 degrees. So one full turn of the helical strand would involve 10 steps or 10 base pairs. That's what I told you. One turn, one full turn having 10 base pairs. If you want to calculate in terms of nucleotides, let it be double, because one base pair is equal to 2 nucleotides. So pitch will be how much? 34 angstroms. Okay, per base pair is going to be, you see, per turn is 34 angstroms. Between two bases means it should be 34 by 10. So it should be 3.4 angstroms. That's why you see here, the distance between here and this is 3.4 angstroms. Be careful, don't get confused. If they ask angstroms, if they ask nanometer, you have to be very clear. If it is 3.4 nanometers means, if you want to convert into angstrom, it is 34 angstroms. Very simple. So this is for the day, guys. Hope you all understand this topic today. So what is our topic today is structure of polynucleotide chain. You can just check it here in this picture. So once again, thank you all the guys who have attended this YouTube sessions. Thank you so much. If you have a doubt, you can raise in the comment box so that I can answer you. If you don't have a doubt, so that I can close the session.